All right, welcome back. We're starting with the MALT. MALT stands for mucosa-associated lymphoid tissue. These are lymphoid tissues found in mucous membranes throughout the body. The MALT protects us from pathogens trying to enter our body. We see the MALT in the mucosa of the respiratory tract, genitourinary tract organs, and the digestive tract. The largest collections of MALT is found in the tonsils, Peyer's patches, and appendix. The tonsils are the simplest lymphoid organs. They form a ring of lymphatic tissue around the pharynx and look like swellings of the mucosa. They are named by location. Palatine tonsils are in the posterior end of the oral cavity. These are the largest of the tonsils and most likely to become infected. Lingual tonsils are at the base of the tongue. Pharyngeal tonsils are also called adenoids and located in the posterior wall of the nasopharynx. Tubal tonsils surround the auditory tubes opening to the pharynx. Tonsils function to gather and remove pathogens in the air and food. They have follicles with germinal centers and scattered lymphocytes. They are not fully encapsulated. The overlying epithelium invaginates, forming tonsillar crypts. Bacteria or particulate matter enters the crypts where it is trapped and destroyed. This allows immune cells to become activated and build memory cells against these pathogens. Figure 20.7 shows the histology of the palatine tonsil, with the germinal centers and the tonsillar crypt. Peyer's patches are clusters of lymphoid follicles in the wall and distal portion of the small intestines. They are also called aggregated lymphoid nodules. They are structurally similar to tonsils. By being located in the small intestines, Peyer's patches can destroy bacteria before they breach the intestinal wall, and also general memory lymphocytes, generate memory lymphocytes. Figure 20.8 shows a histology of a Peyer's patch. The smooth muscle in the intestinal wall is shown here. Just deep to that are the follicles of the Peyer's patch. Next, we come to the appendix. The appendix is an offshoot of the first part of the large intestines. It contains a large number of lymphoid follicles. Its location aids in its ability to destroy bacteria and preventing them from breaching the intestinal wall and to generate memory lymphocytes. Here we see the appendix location in the body, right off of the large intestines. The thymus is a bilobed lymphoid organ in the inferior neck area. It extends into the mediastinum and partially overlies the heart. The thymus is a place where T cells mature. It is most active and largest in size during childhood. It stops growing during adolescence, then gradually atrophies. It continues to produce immunocompetent cells, though more slowly. The thymus is broken into lobules that contain an outer cortex and an inner medulla. The cortex contains rapidly dividing lymphocytes and scattered macrophages. The medulla has fewer lymphocytes than the cortex, and it also has thymic corpuscles. Thymic corpuscles are where regulatory T cells develop. Regulatory T cells are a type of T cell that helps to prevent autoimmunity. The thymus is different from other lymphoid organs because, one, it has no follicles because it lacks the B cells. Two, it does not directly fight antigens. It functions only as a site for T cell maturation. The thymus has a blood-thymus barrier to keep immature T cells isolated from antigens and prevent their premature activation. And lastly, the thymus has a stroma, made up of epithelial cells, not reticular fibers. Figure 20.9 shows a slide of the thymus with the capsule, shown here, the cortex, and the inner medulla. The inner medulla contains thymic corpuscles. And that concludes the end of our lymphatic system lecture.